Very good. Yeah. This is what you are saying in this moment. It is your previous knowledge. Your previous knowledge. This is what you know, okay? About gerund and infinitive. Okay? This is your previous knowledge. Yeah? But now we are going to learn more about this. More. Not just I am cooking, writing. Yeah, this is gerund. This is gerund. And this is gerund. Of course, they are infinitive. Except ask. These are infinitive. Ask is the verb in the base form. Yeah, this is your previous knowledge. Un conocimiento anterior. Previous knowledge. Now, what you are going to learn is more. More about these ones. Gerunds and infinitives, as it says. Okay? Gerunds and infinitives. That is our grammar. Okay? Of course, gerund, as you told me, yes. This is gerund. This is gerund. And this is gerund too. Okay? But now let's check what does the book, the grammar says. Let's analyze, let's check it. And let's open our mind. Okay? Open our mind. Mente, mind, open our mind. A volunteer, who wants to read number three? Volunteers?
Teacher me.
Do it. Do it, Elizabeth.
They read the number three?
Yes, the instruction. Read the instruction.
Okay. Thank you, teacher. Look at the examples in the active grammar books. Then circle the correct underline. Choose the complete each rule.
Yes. What you are going to do is look at the examples in the active grammar box. Look at the example. Examples are here. Look at the examples. Then circle the correct underline choice to complete each rule. Then circle the underline choice to complete it. So here we have, look at. And here we have underlined choice. First of all, we have to study this. And study this. Okay? Okay. Number one, volunteers, who wants to read this part? Who wants to read this? Volunteers?
Me, teacher.
Do it.
I rallied an infantile kid about my feelings.
Yes. I really enjoy talking about my feelings. Yes. Thank you. Second example, volunteers.
Me, teacher.
Do it.
I want to look at your photo album.
Okay. I want to look at your photo. I want to look at your photo. Thank you. Now, Edgar, tell me. Number one, give me the solution. You have two options.
Okay, teacher. Some verbs are followed by Gerund.
Some verbs are for this option.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Volunteers for two.
Teacher.
Me.
Infinitive.
Amalia, read please, read.
Some verbs are followed by infinitive.
By
a infinitive.
Yes. That's right. Why do you say that? Because of the example. Look at want to look.
To look.
Enjoy talking.
Talking.
Yes, talking, talkative, talking. Thank you. What does it mean? What does it mean? It says, I really enjoy. And as you can notice, here we have the verb enjoy. And here we have in the rule one, we have enjoy. And here you have want. And second rule, we have want to. What does it mean? Somebody can explain me in this moment. You can use Spanish if you want. What do you understand? What do you understand about these examples and the use of gerund and infinitive? What do you understand? Speak.
The enjoy is infinitive.
No, enjoy is gerund. Enjoy and gerund. Want and infinitive. What does it mean? Please speak. Nelson, Sandro, ladies. Okay, yeah, your previous knowledge was this. Yeah, you say cooking, writing, watch, yeah. But it says, this, I am cooking, he is watching, they are, I am cooking, he is watching. So they are present progressive. That those are present progressive. Okay? Oh, present progressive. This. I am cooking. Present progressive. He is watching. Also is present progressive.
Chair. Presente continuous. Is it what?
It's the same.
Resulta.
No, it's the same. Present continuous, present progressive. Also, you can say present continuous or present progressive.
Okay, teacher.
Present continuous. Present progressive. Similar. Synonyms, yeah? Good. But now I want you to notice this. This is present continuous. This is present progressive. We are not talking about now this. No, no, eliminate. We are not talking about that. We are talking about just gerund. an infinitive. Ya hicieron an infinitive. Okay. And look at here in the book. Here is not I am talking. No, it says I really enjoy. And we are using a verb. Here, there is a verb, as you can see. There is a verb. Enjoy. I really enjoy. What does enjoy mean? What does enjoy mean?
Disfrutar.
Yes, it's a verb. And this is not present progressive or continuous. This is not present progressive or continuous. No, it is a simple sentence. It's a sentence. But in that sentence, we are using some verbs. Look at it, says some verbs that need or are followed by gerund. Some verbs are followed. What does followed mean? What does followed mean?
I don't know.
Okay.
Seguida.
Seguido.
Seguir.
Yes, that is seguido. Are followed by gerund. Some verbs are followed by gerund. Which verbs? ¿Y dónde están esos verbos? Enjoy, avoid, miss, finish, consider. These verbs are followed by gerund, by a gerund. Example. Let's talk about gerund, okay? Let's talk about gerund. We can say Amalia enjoys. Amalia enjoys. ¿Qué te gusta, Amalia? Enjoys. Enjoys es disfrutar.
Enjoys reading newspaper.
Read. It's not possible to say Amalia enjoys to read. No, because the verb enjoy needs gerund. Follow gerund. Reading.
Music.
No, sorry.
Same reading
books.
Newspaper.
Newspaper
teacher.
Yeah, Amalia enjoys reading newspaper. Okay, Amalia enjoys. So where are our verbs? Look at the verbs. Enjoy, avoid, miss, finish, consider. Now dictate me, please. Enjoyed, avoid, miss. So enjoy, avoid, miss, consider, what else? Enjoy, avoid, miss, and consider.
Finish. Yes.
Yes. And finish. This group of verbs needs to follow gerund. Another example, we can say avoid. Nelson avoids. What do you avoid, Nelson? Tell me. Nelson.
Teacher.
What do you avoid? Eating, drinking.
I don't know, teacher.
Eating, drinking, dancing. Going some parts. What do you avoid?
Sure, what does it mean? Avoid?
Avoid means evadir, evitar.
Thank you, teacher.
Nelson, what do you avoid?
Avoid. A ver, avoid. ¿Qué no me gusta hacer? Avoid.
Evitar.
Cooking.
Yeah. Look at, it's not possible to say Nelson avoids to cook.
Yes.
No. It is cooking. Why? Because enjoy, avoid, miss, consider, finish needs to be followed by gerund. Nelson avoids cooking. Okay. Miss. Thank you, Nelson. Another example. Miss.
Welcome.
Miss, what does miss mean?
Perder.
Yes.
Extrañar.
O extrañar. Faltar. Miss. Extrañar in this case. Okay. Give me your example. I miss
extrañar.
What do you miss? What do you miss? Tell me.
Yo extraño.
I miss
my son.
Yeah.
I miss
dancing. Yeah. And yeah, Celia says, I miss my song. Yeah, this is not gerund, Celia. This is not gerund. But it's okay. It's understandable. But we are using gerund. Gerund after this.
Gerundio.
Enjoy, avoid, miss. Gerund.
Gerundio.
Yes. Okay. I miss dancing. Yeah. I miss dancing. I miss going to university.
I miss eating.
What?
I miss eating. I miss eating chicken. I miss eating pork.
No, the same. Sorry. I miss chicken. I miss eating. Yeah.
Eating chicken.
Consider.
I miss working.
Yeah, in the pandemia you say I miss working. Yes. Consider. What about consider? Consider. I consider, you consider, he considers, she considers. I consider.
Yo considero.
I consider visiting my parents. I consider drinking water. I consider
drinking.
Doing exercises. I consider. Okay? Finish. We can say. Lisette finishes. Lisette finishes writing her presentation. Okay, my friends, consider this. Consider after enjoy, after avoid, after miss, after miss. If you are going to use, si van a usar otro verbo después de esos verbos, if you are going to use another verb after these verbs, use gerund. Use gerund. Gerund, 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 and gerund. Not infinitive. Okay, it says, some verbs are followed by gerund, by gerund. Enjoy, avoid, miss, finish, consider. Number two, in some verbs are followed by a infinitive. Want, seem, offer, decide, hope, afford, promise. Want, seem, afford, decide, hope, promise. So what does it mean? It means that after want, after want, after offer, after seem, after, do you remember? Hope, after,
afford,
offer, decide, afford, and promise. Decide, afford, and promise. Yeah, afford, promise, and decide. Want, offer, seem. I think seem wasn't there, right? Yeah, seem is, it's seem. Want, seem, offer, decide, afford, promise. It says, look at. Tal vez dicen, bueno, son poquitos verbos, rápido, vamos a memorizar. No, there are more, etc. Yeah, but they are the important ones. Sorry, I am laughing. Okay. After those, what do you need? I want. Or Celia, Celia wants. Celia wants.
Celia quiere comer, eating.
No, no eating. No, no eating. No, Celia, because after want, offer, seem, hope, you need. No. What do you need?
To hit.
To.
Infinitive.
Infinitive. Celia wants to dance.
Celia wants to dance, to eat. Celia wants to eat, to dance.
Work, to dance, to run.
Yes, Celia wants to work. Infinity.
Celia quiere trabajar, Celia quiere comer.
Celia, you need infinitive, no gerund. Gerund is with finish. Gerund is with finish.
Excuse me, teacher.
Offer. What about offer?
I sleep, teacher.
Yes, yes, time is over. Offer, offer.
What does mean offer, teacher?
Offer means ofrecer.
Thank you, teacher.
Ofertar, offer.
Infinity.
I offer. I offer.
Offer. Your teacher, Lisette, offer to dress. no. To play. To offer to play.
I offer to play soccer, Wally.
Okay.
I offer to play soccer. Okay. I offer to play Wally. I offer to play to infinitive. Sim. Sim.
Con puro verbos nomás se trabaja, teacher.
After this. Yes, after. Después de esos verbos, infinitive.
After.
Infinitive, infinitive. No, you can say, Celia wants to work. Celia wants to work in Santa Cruz. No, you can say, Celia wants to work in Santa Cruz. Celia wants to work in an office with his mother. What's important? Lo que estamos enseñando es this part. Okay. Celia wants to work. I offer to play. It seems means parece, parecer.
Seems.
Parece que va a llover.
To cost.
It seems to cost.
It seems to rain.
It seems to rain. It seems to rain. It seems to rain. The sky is dark. Okay. It seems to rain. The sky is dark. I hope to speak in English. I hope to speak in English soon. I hope to speak in English.
What does mean hope, teacher?
Please, hope, in hope, Spanish. Hope is esperar. Hope is esperar algo.
Thank you, teacher.
Esperar, pero in your imagination. No, wait. No te
embarazo, esperar.
No.
Eso me equivoco.
Eso es pregnant. I am pregnant.
Okay.
No. Pero puedes desear, o sea, el hope es como un deseo, es más mental. Deseo tener un hijo. I hope to have a baby. Estás embarazada, pero esperas algo, que sea nena o nene. Pero estás embarazada, no de esperar, no, ya estás embarazada. O esperas embarazarte. I hope to be pregnant. I.
Teacher, the other mean the hope is esperanza.
Sí.
In Spanish.
So, como nombre. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
As a noun, muchos verbos son nombres y son verbos. Yeah, muchos verbos son nombres y verbos, pero en este caso estamos hablando de verbo. I hope to have a baby. Yeah. Afford.
What does mean in Spanish afford, teacher?
Afford means volunteers, who knows?
Afford. prometer, decidir.
Pagar.
Yeah. Afford. To pay. Yeah, it can be. It's poder pagar algo.
Permitir, facilitar también dice.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Facilitar. Ya, facilitar, afford. How, what can you afford? Acceder, we can say also. Acceder, afford.
I afford the travel in Chinese.
Okay. Ahora ahí. No siempre va a ser en simple present. It can be in the past. It can be in the future.
I will
effort to travel. Travel to China. I will effort to travel to China. Okay, I will effort to travel to China, you know, in the future. Can be in the past. I afforded. Accedí. Solicité. Me permití to travel to China. I afforded. Okay? To travel. Promise. I promise, we promise, you promise. Or in the past, I promised. Or in the future, I will promise. Or can be with can. I can promise. What is important to use infinitive after that? I promised to. Nelson puede decir, I promise to cook. I promise to cook. Yesterday.
Okay, I promised to cook yesterday, teacher.
Yes, I promised to cook yesterday. Ya, pero lo ha cumplido, estamos hablando de pasado. Entonces, hablemos de futuro. Nelson promises, present. Nelson promises to cook tomorrow. Ya no es pasado. Nelson promises to cook.
Okay, teacher. Mañana puedo cocinar.
Yeah. Promises. Nelson promises. I promise. Okay. And decide. I decide can be past or future. No problem. Future, past, present. I decided. I will decide. Future. I will decide. Oh, future con el be going to. I am going to decide to travel, to go, to work. Infinitive. I am going to decide to buy a car. Future. Okay. Or I decide, past. I decided to buy a car, not a house. I decided. Okay, let's finish. As a summarizing, what do we have? Here is infinitive, infinitive. Okay. Some verbs like want, want, offer, offer, seem, seem, hope, 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 afford, afford, and promise, promise. What else? Decide, decide, decide. They need infinitive. Infinitive. Okay. And enjoy. Enjoy, avoid means they need gerund. Gerund. Enjoy, avoid. Reading is gerund. Cooking, dancing, eating. Oh, you can organize any tense, cualquier oración. But después de estos verbos, what do you need? Gerund and infinitive. Gerund and some verbs needs infinitive. Want, sin promise, etc. Okay, my friends, that is, that was. Questions? What do you have to do? Now you need to memorize. Memorize, memoricen. ¿Qué verbos necesitan gerund? ¿Y qué verbos?
Aquí está, mira. Eli love al mismo tiempo. ¿Te imaginas? Esta es la letra E, L y el I. Cuando lo pones el corazón se vuelve I. Y si lo mezclas acá.
¿Ah? Who is in love? Elizabeth. I don't know who is in love, but somebody's talking about love. Okay. Okay, my friends. That is our grammar for tonight. Okay, that was our grammar.
Gerund. Sorry, teacher, sorry. My microphone is bad. Sorry, teacher.
No, it's okay. Hemos escuchado muy clarito, no está mal. Okay. Okay, this is gerund and infinitives, my friends. Gerund and infinitives. Okay? Some verbs. Some verbs. Okay? We are not talking about progressive, continuous, no. We are talking about... Amalia enjoys reading. Fíjense, esto no es ando, cocinando, comiendo, no, leyendo, no. Amalia enjoys reading. Amalia le gusta leer. Leer. Nelson avoids cooking. Nelson evita cocinar. You know? This is not cocinando. Nelson evita cocinando. No. Solo que estos verbos necesitan gerund. Y se entiende así, como acabo de decirles. Infinitive. Celia wants to work. No problem, right? No problem. Celia wants to work. But, ¿qué tienen que hacer? Tienen que diferenciar entre ese grupo de gerund, verbos que necesitan gerund, y verbos that need infinitive.
Okay?
Homework for tomorrow. Con cada verbo van a hacer su ejemplo ustedes. Y mañana trabajamos en...